Hi everyone, my name is Karen, this is my channel Rather Be Reading, and today I'm bringing to you my hashtag TBR Taketown 5.0 vlog. So first off, the first thing I want to say is apologies that this video is so long. I filmed a lot of clips during this vlog, but let's basically jump straight in to the vlog, which I will insert here for you guys. Hi everyone, it is officially day one of the hashtag TBR Takedown 5.0 readathon. It is actually about 6 p.m. on day one, however, it is a Monday today and I am working all this week as I usually do, so I'm not going to have a super amount of time, like any more than usual, to read during the week. I am actually home tonight though. Normally I'm out on Monday nights, but I will be home tonight, so hopefully that means I will get a bit more reading done tonight than I normally would. Now, however, let's get into things. I have basically decided, I think, to DNF my first read of the readathon. I this morning started Flight by Neil Hetzner. I read a little bit this morning on the bus on the way to work, and I'm only about, sorry, I think I'm 6% of the way through. It is a longer book, so I don't know how many pages that equates to, probably not that many, but I really, really just don't like it. It is very science heavy already. Like, the whole prologue of the story, I basically understood not that much of it, and I thought it was a weird way to start a story, being like that heavy, because like I can't get into it because of it, and I don't really like the writing style, and I really, really don't think I'm going to enjoy it. So I don't want to commit the time, especially in a readathon, to reading, because I think even though I'm reading it on my Kindle, I think it is about, it's over a 400 page book, I'm pretty sure. So it's a big book to try get through when you're not enjoying it. So I'm pretty sure, I haven't officially decided, but I'm really leaning towards DNFing that at this point, and I think I'm just going to pick up Clockwork Prince, which was the book I was going to pick up next. Let me just grab Clockwork Prince. That is also a bigger book. I'm really keep like cutting off half my face. Clockwork Prince is another big book. I think it's around just under 500 pages. But I generally get through like the Mortal Instruments and the Infernal Devices books pretty quickly. So I don't know. I think I'm going to pick that up next. As I said, if you saw my February TBR where I talked about the readathon, I'm not specifically trying to check off any challenges. I am listening to the audiobook also, I should mention, of George by Alex Gino. None of my other holds had come in, and so I was looking for like a shorter book so that I could finish it quickly on audio in case my hold does come in. So I got that out because it's only about a 4-hour audiobook. I'm most of the way through it. I think I'm at about 80%. So I'll probably finish that off tomorrow morning on the bus on the way to work, but I am reading that as well, and I probably will use that to check off the challenge of a book outside of your comfort zone, as that is a middle grade novel and I do not read a lot of middle grade. So yeah, that's basically where I'm up to. So this turned into a really long update. I'll probably leave it there for now. I will check in. I don't know if I'll check in tonight. I may before I go to bed. If not, I'll probably check in tomorrow when I get home from work, but I will talk to you guys soon. Hi guys, it is now about 10 p.m., just after 10 p.m. on day one. I just finished getting ready for bed, so apologies for the shitty lighting, but I've already turned off my overhead light and just have my lamp on. I just spent the evening basically watching some YouTube, well, BookTube videos and reading my book. So I'm actually on page 101 right now of Clockwork Prince. So I've totaled it up, and so far today with the pages from George by Alex Gino, the few pages of the book that I read that I DNF'd, and the pages that I've read of Clockwork Prince, I've read about 279 pages so far today. I'll probably read about another 20 or 30 pages before I go to bed, so I'm probably looking at about 300 pages for day one, which is a lot more actually than I anticipated, so I'm really, really happy with that. I'm glad to have got a lot read today actually, because I know that tomorrow and Thursday night I have things on after work both of those nights, so I probably won't get as much read on either of those 2 days. But yeah, I'm going to sign off now for the night, and as I said, I'll probably check in with you guys when I get home from work tomorrow before I head out. So, see you later. Hi guys, it is currently, what time is it? 10 past 6 p.m. on the second day of TBR Takedown. I got home from work about 5 minutes ago. I didn't get a lot of reading done during the day today. I did manage to complete the audiobook of George by Alex Gino, so that accounted for about 60 pages, and I did read about 35 pages of Clockwork Prince. So I'm looking at about 95 pages so far. I would like to at least get to 200 pages today, but I'm not too sure whether that's going to happen. I have to leave home in about 20 minutes to go to training. It's actually my first training back since I dislocated my knee, so I've literally basically done no physical activity apart from rehab with my physio since August, so I'm really not looking forward to it. It's going to be brutal, but anyway, I need to get back out there, so I'm off to that. Like I said, I've got to leave in about 20 minutes, and I won't be home probably till between 8:30 and 9, and then I need to have a shower and eat dinner. So I'll get as much reading as I can in when I get home, but I just don't know if I'm going to get much read today. But anyway, that is it for this little update. I'll probably update you guys again maybe before I go to bed. So I'll talk to you guys then. All right, guys, quick update. It was brutal, but I survived, so that's good. And my knee actually held up really well, so I'm really, really pleased. I'm glad that I did it, even though I feel absolutely fucking shattered. So I am going to take hopefully the world's quickest shower because I'm so tired and I'm so hungry, and then hopefully get some reading done before I have to head to bed. Hi guys, I just wanted to film this really quick update. It's about 11 p.m. now on day two. I didn't get anywhere near as much read today as I would have liked to. I got to page 200 and just over 200 of Clockwork Prince. So I read about, I don't know, 60, 70 pages of that today. And together with the pages that I finished on the audiobook of George, all up, I think I've read about 130 pages today. I was hoping to get to around 200 pages each day of the readathon, but today's just been really busy and I'm absolutely shattered right now. I'm so tired. So I'm gonna turn off my light and go to sleep now, and hopefully I have a better reading day tomorrow. See you then. Hi guys, apologies if I look like total shit right now. I just got home from work and I had to walk from my bus stop to home, and it is 42 degrees Celsius outside right now, which is equivalent to about 108 Fahrenheit. So it is absolutely friggin' sweltering. Anyway, it is currently about 6 p.m. on day three of TBR Takedown. I managed to read about 60 pages of Clockwork Prince on my like commute today, and I've also read about 16% of an audiobook that I started, which is called The Drowning House by Elizabeth Black. None of my other holds came in, so I just got this one because it was on the available now. Sounded fairly interesting. It had gothic in the subject, so I decided to give it a go. So that's all I've managed to read so far today. I'll check in with you guys a little bit later, probably before I head to bed, or maybe at some point, just to let you guys know. I don't have anything on tonight, so hopefully I can get a good amount of reading done. Hi guys, so it is currently 9 p.m. I'm still on day three. However, I have not read a single word since I last spoke to you. Last night, my laptop was going through like updates, but like extensive updates, and I couldn't use it at all. And when I got home from work today, it was still updating, and it turned out it had frozen. I don't know, I googled all about it. I had to remove all the USB devices that I had plugged into it, like for my mouse. So I did that and it finally started again. But while I was waiting for those updates to finish so I could use the laptop, because I do have a video that I need to edit to get uploaded tomorrow morning. I want my Masters 2 read video for January, I believe, to be uploaded tomorrow. And so while I was waiting for that, I fell asleep. So it is currently 9 p.m. Like I say, I just woke up. I've literally been asleep for about 2 hours. I was so exhausted last night, and then I got up at about 10 to 6 this morning so that I could go for a run before work. It all just caught up with me. So, yeah, I haven't read a single word. My laptop is now just now finally working, and I still have to edit this video, and I haven't even eaten dinner. So, I don't know what's gonna happen. I'll check back in with you guys later. Okay, so it's just after 10 p.m. It's about 10 past 10. My video that I would need to upload tonight is currently exporting. That'll take a little bit, and then I need to upload it to YouTube, which always takes a while. So I'm probably gonna set it to upload and like fill out everything, like all the details, like include all the links in the description. Because if you guys didn't know, I always leave links to all the books that I talk about in videos in the description box. So I need to do that, and then I'll probably go to bed and I'll leave my computer on overnight for it to upload to YouTube, and then I'll publish it in the morning. Before I leave for work, because I think if I have to wait for it to export and upload to YouTube, I won't be getting to bed till like midnight, and I'm already been really tired this week, so I don't want to do that. So I have, since I last updated you, read 10 pages of Clockwork Prince. I'm just watching a YouTube video at the moment. I was kind of watching on and off at points in the editing process when I didn't need to hear the video. So I'll probably finish off that video and then hopefully read for a bit, little bit while this exports. So I might check in with you guys before I go to bed, or I might check in with you guys maybe even in the morning if I have time in the morning before work or tomorrow after work. But I will speak to you guys soon. All right, guys, this is my final update for day three. It is currently 11:30 p.m. I did manage to get my video that's going up tomorrow, so it'll be up by the time you guys see this, obviously, completely uploaded, so I don't need to do anything for that in the morning. And so that's really good, because I am planning to set my alarm to hopefully get up to do some more exercise in the morning, but I don't know how that's going to go because I'm quite tired. I hope I'm going to be able to get off to sleep all right now that I had that like 2.5 hour long nap. I have managed to read about another 30 pages of Clockwork Prince since I last spoke to you guys. So I think in total today in Clockwork Prince, I've read a total of about 100 pages in this, and then about 50 pages, I think it worked out to be, in the audiobook of The Drowning House. So I have read about 150 pages today. Like I said yesterday, I was hoping to average about 200 pages a day, which is not generally difficult for me. I've mentioned in a lot of videos that my life starts to get really busy like around March, and I feel like maybe this year it's just kicking off like a lot earlier. I've been so busy already. I mean, not tonight. Tonight I just fell asleep. But tomorrow, I have a hair appointment after work. At 6, so I probably won't get home till like 8:30 again tomorrow night. I maybe be able to get some reading done at my hair appointment though, hopefully. So yeah, I won't be home till like 8:30 again tomorrow night, and then hopefully I can get some good amount of reading done across Friday and across the weekend. I generally actually get less reading done on weekends than I do during the week. I don't know if that's unusual, but that's generally how it works for me. But hopefully this weekend, I don't have anything going on that I can think of off the top of my head, so hopefully that means I will be able to get a good chunk of reading done. Like, even for example, in this book, Clockwork Prince, this is now the third day that I've been reading this, and I'm only just about halfway through, and that's very unusual for me. I normally finish a book on average in about 3, maybe 4 days. Like, and maybe I will finish this tomorrow, like, I don't know, but. And it is quick reading, like this is an easy to read like book, so I don't know, it's just been a bit of a crazy week for me. Anyway, I can already tell this vlog is going to be so long because I filmed so many clips, but I just really enjoy vlogging. So I will check in with you guys tomorrow. I say I don't know when it will be because I don't know like what time I'll be up in the morning. I normally don't have time to film before I leave for work. And I'm not going to be home, as I said, until like 8:30 tomorrow, because I'm going straight to my hair appointment from work. Maybe I'll take my camera with me actually and vlog in the car when I'm driving to my appointment. That might be a good idea actually. I might do that, and then I'll be able to update you guys when I'm like after I've finished work. So, and anyway, I will check in with you guys at some point tomorrow. Bye. Hi guys. Apologies if all you can hear right now is my air conditioner, but I've turned my car on because I just walked from
the bus to the parking garage, and it's 42 degrees outside right now, so I'm sweating up a storm. So it is day 4 of the readathon. It's currently about 10 to 6. I'm just about to drive from here to my hair appointment. I got absolutely nothing of Clockwork Prince read today. Because I had this hair appointment, I had to park in the parking garage and go from here. So it means I'm a bit closer. So it meant that my commute was shorter, so I didn't have as much time to read. I did have so far listened to about 16% of the audiobook I'm listening to, The Drowning House. So I will be listening to that in the car now on the way to the hairdresser and from the hairdresser home. So I'll get a bit more of that read, and hopefully I'll have some time maybe at my appointment to read some of Clockwork Prince and when I get home. But I will check in with you guys later.
Hi guys, it is now, what time is it? About 10 past 8 p.m. I just got home from my hair appointment. I got a lot of it topped off and I actually cut into it a lot. It feels so much better. I don't think I realized how heavy it had gotten until she was cutting it, and then I was just like, holy crap, thank God. It is absolutely sweltering here. I know I'm complaining about the heat a lot in this video, but it is after 8 p.m. and it is still 36 degrees Celsius, which is still like 98 Fahrenheit. Like, it's ridiculous. I'm like, have come inside my house and I'm like sitting here sweating, like it's disgusting. So I only managed to read about 15 pages of Clockwork Prince at the hairdresser. I am now at, let me just check my audiobook. I have read about 20% of my audiobook today, which is good. I'm obviously home now, so I'm just heating up some dinner, and then I'll just be sitting here eating some dinner, doing a bit of reading, a bit of YouTube watching. That's my plans for the rest of the night. But yeah, I'll probably check in with you guys maybe before I go to bed. So talk to you guys soon. All right, folks, it is currently 10:30 p.m. I'm just about to turn off my light to go to sleep. I'm now on page 415 of Clockwork Prince. I managed to get about 80 pages read of that today, plus about 60 pages of the audiobook. So all up, I've read about 140 pages today. Not as much as I would like. It's definitely my worst reading day so far of the readathon, but as I said, I have nothing going on basically from Friday night through the weekend. So hopefully I can get a lot of reading done then. So I will talk to you guys tomorrow. Hi guys, it is currently about 20 past 8 p.m. on Friday, day 5 of TBR Takedown. I actually got home from work and I literally left the house about 3 minutes later to go watch my dad play in a 7-a-side soccer competition. And I have mucho regret about making that decision to go, because I don't keep complaining about the heat, but it was like 39 again, like here today, and now because I'm only just gotten home and it's like 20 past 8, my air conditioning's obviously been off all day and my house is like a freaking sauna. Anyway, so I did today get more reading done during my work day, which is really exciting. I finished Clockwork Prince on my lunch break. So I finished that. I really, really enjoyed it. I actually thought that the plot maybe wasn't as good as in the first book, but the relationships and the characters and stuff, like 10 out of 10 would recommend. So I'll talk about that more in my mid-month wrap-up. But yes, I finished that. I did listen to a chunk of my audiobook. Ooh, I've never done like moving vlog before. This is difficult. Let me get my phone. Oh, hello, my messy wardrobe. Let me tell you where I got to on my audiobook. So because I had finished my book on lunch and I hadn't taken a backup book, because rookie mistake, I just listened to my audiobook all the way home, so I should have got through a chunk of it. I did. I listened to about, oh my God, math. Well, I was on 38% and now I'm on 62%. So what is that? I'm normally actually quite good at math, but I can't. 22, what's that, like 26, 24, 24% today, which is pretty decent. So that's good. And I'm now, like I said, 62%. I would like to finish that before the readathon ends, just for like completeness, but I don't think I will, because I don't get very much audiobook listening done on the weekends. I normally only listen to it in my car if I'm driving somewhere, and I don't generally drive a lot. Even on weekends. So like if I'm going somewhere with my parents just drive. So anyway, so I think now, like tonight, I'm planning to pick up Dirty Tricks by Emily Rodda. This is a children's small story. This probably has about 120 pages, because that's generally what they are. Ooh, shorter one. 110 pages. So I will be reading that. This will actually work though for the challenge of a book from your most recent book haul, because I did just haul this in my January book haul. So that's really good. So I think so far Clockwork Prince works for the challenge of a book that's been on your TBR for over a year, because I've owned the Infernal Devices and the Mortal Instruments for ages. So that works for that. And then George by Alex Gino works for the challenge of a book outside of your comfort zone, because it's middle grade and I do not read a lot of middle grade. I don't think I'll check off either of the other two challenges, which is starting a series and finishing or catching up on a series. There's no way I'm going to get to like another book in the Mortal Instruments, or like I've got two Mortal Instruments books. I'm definitely not finishing that, and I'm not planning to pick up Clockwork Princess yet, like I would pick up City of Lost Souls if I was going to pick up any of them. But once I finish Dirty Tricks, I will be moving on to Spinning again. Sorry, I'm getting redder as I speak because my house is friggin' boiling. I'll be picking up Murder on the Orient Express by Agatha Christie once I finish that. I'll probably just read that tonight, see what like kind of mood I am, but I'm really hot and I just kind of want to lay on my couch and like basically lay like a blob. So that's basically my plans. I'll probably check in before I go to bed and let you know whether I finished Dirty Tricks, which I should be able to do, like I say, and then hopefully if I can read Murder on the Orient Express on Saturday and Sunday and get that finished as well, that would be good. And then after Murder on the Orient Express, I do have to pick up Hot Pursuit by Emily Rodda. This is the next book after Dirty Tricks, so it's another short one. So if I could get through all three of those, sorry, I keep cutting my face off, that would be pretty awesome. So yeah, I'm pretty, like I say, I haven't got as much reading done as I would have liked to during the readathon, but you know, life happens. So yeah, I will check in with you guys later. I'm sorry, I've rambled so much in these vlogs. Talk to you later.
Hi guys, so it is now 25 past 1 in the morning. So technically it's now day 6 of the readathon, and you must be thinking, wow, you must have got a lot of reading done in the past few hours. I'm on page 19 of Dirty Tricks. I've read 18 pages. However, I did manage to binge watch 3.5 hours of Married at First Sight. I don't know if they have this show in other countries. This is like a reality show where expert, I use that term loosely, matchmakers match couples together and they get married. Like when they first meet, they literally meet at the wedding ceremony. I've never watched it before. This is like the 4th or 5th season. I've never watched it before, and I wasn't even the beginning of the season that I was watching. I was just flicking through channels and they had like encore episodes that they do here, and they had like 3 episodes on in a row, and it's that each episode's like longer than an hour, and I just literally, I couldn't look away. It was like watching a car crash. So I'm not too worried that I haven't read that much of Dirty Tricks. Like I say, I can get through Dirty Tricks, and I know I can also get through Agatha Christie like really quickly as well. So I'm expecting to be able to finish at least both of those two this weekend. Married at First Sight, you know, binge watchers notwithstanding. So I'm not too worried. I am probably not going to read any more tonight. I'm just going to get ready for bed and go to sleep because I am exhausted, because I don't normally stay up this late on a Friday night, because I normally get up at about 8 on Saturdays. So I'm now regretting not just turning off freaking Married at First Sight, but you know, we all make mistakes. But I will check in with you guys tomorrow and let you know how my reading's going. Hi guys, it is now, I always forget to check the time right until I'm filming. It is 25 past 10 in the morning on Saturday, day 6 of the readathon. I've been up and out and about. I was up at about 8 o'clock. I generally go out for coffee and like to the shops with my parents and my nan on Saturday mornings. So I've been out there, had a coffee and some raisin toast, and I actually bought 2 dresses while I was out, which was really exciting. We have a store here in Australia called Noni Bee. It's like an older lady store. But as I was walking past, I saw a dress on the rack that actually had like quite a nice pattern on it. And it was just like a fitted kind of dress that I was like, oh, that would be actually a really good dress to wear to work. But it can be quite expensive, that store as well. And I saw the sign on top of it and it was like now $50. And I was like, oh, $50 is not too bad. And then I looked at the price tag on it and it had been $170 and it was on sale down to $250. So I tried on that one and another one that was on the same rack. So I got 2 dresses for $50 each, which is pretty good for like good quality dresses that I'll be able to wear to work. And I'm actually going to a wedding in a couple of weeks.
And I think one of them, I have another dress that I was planning to wear to the wedding, but one of the ones that I bought would also be a good option for the wedding. Anyway, I'm going on a complete random, it's completely unrelated to the readathon. Anyway, I was letting you guys know, I haven't read anything since I last checked in. I have no plans for the rest of Saturday, like, at all. I may contact my sister this afternoon, because I am planning to see my sister tomorrow, but I'll be seeing just her tomorrow. And I haven't seen my niece and nephew in about 2 weeks, which is like the longest I've gone without seeing them in ages, and I miss their cute little faces. So I don't know, I may end up going around to her place this afternoon just to like say hello and see my niece and nephew. But apart from that, I literally have no plans. I'll just be lazing about today, watching YouTube and reading and maybe watching a movie or some Gossip Girl. I really need to finish Gossip Girl. I only have 5 episodes to go, but I just can't seem to like, I'm all right when I'm watching it. I can sit there and watch like 3 episodes, but every time I stop watching, I can't be bothered to like put it on again. Like I don't have the motivation to finish it, even though I've got 5 episodes to go. But that wedding I am going to that I just mentioned, the wedding's in Canberra. I used to live in Canberra before I lived in Adelaide, for those of you who don't know. And a friend of mine from there is getting married. And I'm going over there for her wedding. And another friend of mine who is also going to be at the wedding, we're sitting on a table together and stuff. She is the main one who I talk to Gossip Girl about and who's like been pushing me to finish it. And I have to finish it before I go to the wedding or she will kill me. So I may watch some of that today. But yeah, apart from that, hopefully I'll just get a lot of reading on, like I say. So I will check in with you guys like later on today and let you know how I'm going, what I've been up to.
Hi guys, it is now just after 3 p.m, about 10 past 3 on Saturday, day 6. I have finished Dirty Tricks by Emily Rodda. It was a lot of fun. I actually really, really enjoyed it. And I have read a chapter of Murder on the Orient Express. So I'm on page 25. I am now just about to head to my sister's. I'll probably be there for an hour or two just to see my precious babies. So yeah, I'll be there for about an hour or two. And then, as I said, I have no other plans for all of Saturday. I will be home all night. I also spent a bit of time just now editing my You're Not Good Enough book tag, which again will be up before this vlog. So I need to upload that when I get home because I want that to go up tonight. But that's fine. It's all edited. I just need to upload it. So that's not going to take me any time or anything. It's not any work required. It'll take time, but there's not any work required really. So that's it. And I'll probably just like watch a movie and do some more reading and watch some more BookTube. But I will check in with you guys a little later on.
Hi guys, it is currently about 20 past 8 p.m. Now I spent a couple of hours at my sister's place with my delightful little niece and nephew. Got my, hug ratio in for a while. So that was really nice. And then came home basically and had a nap. And I've just been watching a bit more BookTube and doing a bit of reading. I'm now on page 53 of Murder on the Orient Express. I haven't read that much. And I am now just cooking some dinner and I'm going to watch a movie. I'm going to watch Munich, which I've been meaning to watch for a while, but it's like 3 hours long. So I've been putting it off because it's such a long movie. But I'm going to watch that now. And then once I finish that, I'll probably go to bed and just read for a while. And like get a chunk of this book read. Hopefully, like I said, I've read hardly for any amount of time so far today. And I've still, like since I started Murder on the Orient Express, and I've still read 50 pages. Like it's a really quick, easy reading, Agatha Christie. So I say if I just spend even like half an hour straight reading before I go to bed tonight, I should be able to get a chunk of that read. But I'll probably check in with you guys before I head to sleep. Hi guys, it is 10 past 12 in the morning, so technically day 7 now of the readathon. I did just basically eat dinner and watch Munich. I haven't really read anything else. I've basically just decided to sit here and edit the clips of this vlog that I have so far, and I'm so sorry you guys. This vlog so far is 26 minutes long, and that only includes one of the clips from today. And so I have like a clip or two before this, plus this clip and any clips that I film tomorrow still to go in. So this vlog is probably going to be about half an hour long. I apologize, but I just really do enjoy updating you guys on my life and like what's happening throughout the readathon. So I apologize. But as I said, I haven't really got anything read now, but I'm just basically going to go get ready for bed, and I'm going to get into bed, and I'm probably going to just read for about half an hour before I turn my light. I don't need to be up for anything tomorrow. I'm actually not sure what's happening. Originally, I was planning to spend the day, not the day, but I was planning to spend some time with my sister tomorrow. But when I went around to her house today, she said she didn't know what was happening because she was going to come around here because her husband and kids had plans, but now she doesn't know if those plans are going through. And I had forgotten that there are a couple of games on tomorrow that I would normally go to, which I would like to go to because I always go. So that's not until the afternoon though, so I don't have anything on until tomorrow afternoon. So I'm probably, like I say, I'm on page, I can't remember what page I was on last time I updated you guys. I think it's the same page though. Yeah, I'm on page 53 of Murder on the Orient Express, which I think I was where I was at last time. I am aiming to get to probably about at page 100 of this before I go to sleep, but that will not be difficult. That will seriously probably take me like less than half an hour. Because this is really easy reading, and this is like a mass market paperback size too, so the pages are small. It's a really like spaced out font, and like the font is not like small or anything. Like, this is super easy reading, so I will easily be able to get to page 100 in this before I go to sleep tonight. In fact, I might even read further than that, just like depend how tired I am as I'm reading, and then hopefully I can finish this tomorrow, because I would really like to finish the readathon just with having finished this one. So yeah, I may check in with you when I'm going to sleep, or I may just check in with you in the morning, but I will let you know.
Hi guys, it is just after 1 in the morning, so I'm about to turn off my light. I am on page 156 or something like that of Murder on the Orient Express. So, as I say, I can fly through this book so quickly. I could probably read the whole thing tonight if I really wanted to, but I don't want to stay up, like, ridiculously late. Like, it's already 1 a.m. So, I'm going to go to sleep now. I think, today I end up reading about 250 pages, which I'm really happy with. So, tomorrow, at the very least, I would like to finish Murder on the Orient Express, as I've said, but I will check in with you guys, throughout the day tomorrow. Hi guys, it is 9:30 a.m. on Sunday, day 7 of the readathon. I've been awake for about an hour. I was just laying in bed, like, you know, checking my Facebook and Twitter and Instagram and all those things for a while. And now I've kind of gotten up and brushed my teeth and gotten dressed, kind of. Now my sister is actually coming around probably just after 10, and we are going to watch some Buffy. My sister normally comes around on Friday nights after work, but her husband is playing in a 7-a-side soccer competition, and so she's looking after her kids, so she can't come around on Friday nights, at the moment for a few weeks. So she's coming around today because her husband's going out with the kids, basically. So she's coming around, we're going to watch some Buffy, we're rewatching a Buffy, and I'm rewatching Angel, and she's watching Angel for the first time. We're kind of watching them like in conjunction together. So she's coming around, probably watch a few episodes of that, and then I am heading out, to, soccer for, I'll probably be there most of the afternoon. I need to be there. I don't need to be there. Games start at 1, so I'll probably get there just like right at 1. My parents will be there and be set up and stuff with our chairs, so I'll just go right at 1 and we'll meet them there. I'll probably be there most of the rest of the afternoon, so it's actually turning into a day where I'm not sure how much reading I'm going to get done. As I said, it's about 9:30 now. I have about 30-40 minutes before my sister comes around, so I am just about to put on a load of washing because, you know, adult life, and if I don't put on that washing, then I'll have nothing to wear to work for the whole next week. So, yeah, I need to put on a load of washing, and then I'm probably just going to sit here and read Murder on the Orient Express until my sister gets here. But I'll check in with you guys, maybe between when my sister leaves and when I head to the soccer, or I'm not sure, but I'll check in with you guys later. Hi guys, it is just after 5 p.m. on the last day of the readathon. As I mentioned, my sister came around. I then went out and was out all day, basically all afternoon at soccer, where it wasn't that hot today. The temperature really dropped off. It was about 24 degrees, but looks like I got a little bit of sun on my nose, and I also got really badly burnt. I don't know if you can see on my arms. So that's really upsetting. I'll probably put on some after sun gel. Straight away when I got home, I read about 30 pages this morning before my sister came around, and then I've read... What did that take me to? I don't know. I've read like
basically, I'm on page 213 now. I read a little bit just when I came home, and then I just literally took like a 20-minute power nap because being out in the sun just like completely sapped all my energy. I'm just about to head around to my parents' place to go have pizza for dinner, and then when I get home, I'll definitely be able to finish this tonight. Like, I'm not concerned about it. As I said, it's such easy reading. There's 347 pages, so I've got about 130 pages to go, but that's no worries. I will take this book with me to my parents, so I may get a little bit of it read while I'm around there, just depending on what we're doing. But yeah, I'll check in with you guys probably before I go to bed, so see you then. Hi guys, it is 10 to 10 p.m. on day 7. I have just finished Murder on the Orient Express. I'm feeling quite sorry for myself. I don't know if you can see, my face has come up a little bit redder, even more so, and my arms and such, and my chest here and everything has come up really red, and I'm actually burnt on my legs as well. And I did put sunscreen on a couple of times, but I obviously was just not vigilant enough, and it's actually quite sore and hot. So I'm feeling quite sorry for myself. So I did just finish, and I'm also really tired being out in the sun. I don't know, when you haven't been out in the sun like a lot and then you're out in the sun for like a long time, it just is such an energy sap. But like, I'm so tired right now. So I did just finish Murder on the Orient Express, like I said. So overall today, I believe I've read about 190 pages, which is not too bad. I don't think I'm going to read anything else tonight. Like I said, I'm feeling quite sorry for myself and tired. And I've also got a bit of a headache, I think, from being in the sun too. So I think I'm just going to get ready for bed and go to sleep. I mean, it's 10 to 10, so I'd be heading off to sleep pretty shortly anyway, because I have work tomorrow and I am hoping to get up and go for a run in the morning. So yeah. So that's basically it, I think, for this readathon update. I hope you guys have enjoyed this vlog, but that is all I have for these updates. I will, I'll have an outro now, which I'll switch to, which I'll give you like kind of my final statistics. So bye guys. So as you will see from those vlog clips, the readathon ended up being a lot busier than I had originally anticipated, but I did still manage to finish up the readathon with a total of 85 pages, which my initial goal was to read about 200 pages a day, which would have been 1400 pages. So I was very close to that, so I'm pretty happy. I had a really fun time during the readathon. I managed to complete 3 of the challenges, which was a book outside of your comfort zone, a book that's been on your TBR for over a year, and a book from your most recent book haul. The only 2 challenges I didn't complete was to finish or catch up on a series and to start a series. But I said right from the get-go that I wasn't going to actively be trying to complete challenges, just whatever was on my normal TBR that happened to check off challenges. That's what I was going to do. So again, I'm really, really happy. I would love to chat with you guys in the comments down below if you participated in the readathon, how you did, or if you enjoyed this vlog style video. Again, apologies that it is so, so long. So I'd just love to chat with you guys in the comments. Please like this video if you liked it. Please subscribe if you want to see more from my channel. But that's all I've got for this video today. Bye guys.